Hello everyone, in this video we are discussing about the production, harvest and recovery of enzymes. The commercial production and use of enzymes is a major part of biotechnology industry. The first enzyme produced industrially was tacadiastase in 1896 in United States. It was used as a pharmaceutical agent to cure digestive disorders. The different organisms and their relative contribution for the production of commercial enzymes. Its relative percentage is given here. Fungi 60%, bacteria 24%, yeast 4%, streptomyces 2%, higher animal 6% and higher plants 4%. Enzymes from animal and plant sources. These are some enzymes and their source and their applications. And first one is beta amylase. It is obtained from barley and soybean. It is used for baking and preparation of maltose syrup. Second one is bromelain. It is obtained from pineapple and it is used for baking. The third enzyme esterase obtained from wheat and it is used for ester hydrolysis. Ficin is another enzyme obtained from fig. It is used as a meat tenderizer. Papain obtained from papaya and it is a meat tenderizer used for tanning and baking. Peroxidase is obtained from horseradish. Urea is obtained from jack bean and both these enzymes are used for diagnostic purpose. These are some enzymes obtained from animal sources. Amylase, esterase, pepsin, trypsin, lipase, renin, phospholipase, phytase are obtained from lamb, calf, bovine and porcine, which is used for digestive aid and preparation of cheese. Lysozyme obtained from hen egg, it is used for cell wall breakage in bacteria. Human urine is used for dissolution of blood clot. Animal organs and tissues are very good sources for enzymes such as lipase, esterase and protease. The enzyme lysozyme is mostly obtained from hen eggs. Some plants are excellent sources for certain enzyme papain and bromelain. Drawbacks associated with the manufacture of enzymes from animal and plant sources. There are some difficulties in isolating and purifying the enzymes and the cost factor is very high. As regards extraction of industrial enzymes from bovine sources, there is a heavy risk of contamination with bovine spongiform encephalopathy. For these reasons, microbial production of enzymes is preferred. Enzymes from microbial sources. Microorganisms are the most significant and convenient source of commercial enzymes. Microorganisms can be cultivated by using inexpensive media and production can take place in a short period. In addition, it is easy to manipulate microorganisms in genetic engineering techniques to increase the production of desired enzymes. Recovery, isolation, and purification processes are easy with microbial enzymes than that with animal or plant sources. A selected list of enzymes, microbial sources and the application. Amylase. Aspergillus niger, Aspergillus oryzae and Bacillus subtilis are the source of amylase enzyme. It is used for the production of beer and alcohol, and it is used as a digestive aid and used for the preparation of glucose syrup. Cellulase. Aspergillus niger, Rhizopus niveus are the sources of cellulase enzyme. It is used for starch hydrolysis. Pectinase. Aspergillus species Sclerotina libertina are the sources of pectinase enzyme. It is used for the clarification of juice and wine, alcohol production and coffee concentration. Saccharomyces cerevisiae is a source of invertase enzyme used for sucrose inversion and preparation of artificial honey. Aspergillus niger is a source of protease enzyme. It is a digestive aid and substitute of carfrenate. Aspergillus niger is a unique organism for the production of enzymes. There are well over 40 commercial enzymes that are conveniently produced by Aspergillus niger. These include alpha amylase, cellulase, protease, lipase, pectinase, and etc. The technology of enzyme production. There are 4 steps: selection of organisms, formulation of medium, production process, recovery and purification of enzymes. First step, selection of organism. The organism should produce the maximum quantities of desired enzyme in a short time, while the amount of other metabolite produced are minimal. Once the organism is selected, strain improvement for optimizing the enzyme production can be done by appropriate methods like use of mutagens and UV rays, etc. From the organism chosen, inoculum can be prepared in a liquid medium. Second stage, formulation of medium. The culture medium chosen should contain all the nutrients to support adequate growth of microorganisms that will ultimately result in good quantities of enzyme production. The ingredients of the medium should be readily available at low cost and are nutritionally safe. Some of the commonly used substrates for the medium are starch hydrolysate, molasses, corn steep liquor, yeast extract, whey and soya bean meal. Some cereals and pulses have also been used. The pH of the medium should be kept optimal for good microbial growth and enzyme production. Third step, production process. Industrial production of enzyme is mostly carried out by submerged liquid conditions and to a lesser extent by solid substrate fermentation. In submerged culture technique, the yield are more and the chances of infection are less. Hence, this is a preferred method. However, solid substrate fermentation is historically important and still in use for the production of fungal enzymes. Example, amylases, cellulases, proteases and pectinases. The medium can be sterilized by employing batch or continuous sterilization techniques. The fermentation is started by inoculating the medium. The growth conditions, that is pH, temperature, oxygen supply and nutrient addition, are maintained at optimal levels. The froth formation can be minimized by adding anti-foam agents. The production of enzyme is mostly carried out by batch fermentation and to a lesser extent by continuous process. The bioreactor system must be maintained sterile throughout the fermentation process. The duration of fermentation is variable around 2 to 7 days in most production processes. Besides the desired enzyme, several other metabolites are also produced. The enzymes have to be recovered and purified. Fourth step, recovery and purification of enzymes. The desired enzyme produced may be excreted into the culture medium or may be present within the cells. Depending on the requirement, the commercial enzyme may be crude or highly purified. Further, it may be in a solid or liquid form. The steps involved in downstream process, that is, recovery and purification steps, employed will depend on the nature of the enzyme and the degree of purity desired. The recovery of an extracellular enzyme which is present in the broth is relatively simpler compared to an intracellular enzyme. For the release of intracellular enzymes, special techniques are needed for cell disruption. Microbial cells can be broken down by physical means like sonication, high pressure, and glass beads. The cell wall of the bacteria can be lysed by the enzyme lysozyme, and for yeast, the enzyme beta-glucanase is used. The most important consideration is to minimize the loss of desired enzyme activity. First one, removal of cell debris. Filtration or centrifugation can be used to remove the cell debris. Removal of nucleic acids. Nucleic acids can be precipitated and removed by adding polycations such as polyamines, streptomycin, and polyethylenamine. Enzyme precipitation. Enzymes can be precipitated by using salt, that is ammonium sulfate, organic solvents like isopropanol, ethanol, and acetone, etc. Liquid-liquid partition. Further concentration of desired enzymes can be achieved by liquid-liquid extraction using polyethylene glycol and polyamines. Separation by chromatography. Chromatographic techniques for separation and purification of enzymes include ion exchange, size exclusion, affinity, hydrophobic interaction, etc. Drying and packing. The concentrated form of the enzyme can be obtained by drying. This can be done by film evaporators or freeze dryers. This is the outline of production of enzymes.